Dr. Kim Hammond from the Falls Road Animal Hospital is here to answer your pet questions now, and James is with him. Is he a cutie or what?
James is a little toy poodle, and I think the batteries have run down a little bit in this particular toy. You know, I have two of these. They grow up to be the coolest dogs in the whole world. Right now, they're just a fluff.
He looks pretty cool to me right now.
Oh,
and what is he, 10 weeks old?
I mean,
tiny.
Yeah, tiny. He's a toy, but he's going to get he'll get a little bit bigger.
All right, well, let's get to some questions while James just chills right now.
Okay.
This one, I live in the city and have backyard chickens. One is swelling in the neck, and I can't find anyone who will treat her. Any suggestions?
Well, first of all, yes, I treat chickens. Falls Road Animal Hospital treats chickens. But I have to tell you, chickens are the new rage. They're everywhere. And
my sister has them.
Exactly.
She just got 12 of them.
Where does your sister live?
She lives up in Pennsylvania.
But where? In a city, like a little town?
No, like in the outskirts of Philly. Yeah.
Outskirts of Philly, right. That is not chicken territory.
It's
Maryland,
not.
Eastern Shore is chicken territory. But that's the point. They're all over. Now, let me talk to you about that swelling in the neck. That's a very, very serious problem. Generally, there's something in the crop. Perhaps the nesting that they're sitting on, perhaps it's straw or something like that, and they're eating it and it gets clogged. You have to go to your veterinarian today, and get that fixed.
All right.
Okay.
Next one, I want to get my cats declawed, but have gotten a lot of conflicting information. What's your take on this?
Okay, so this is a controversial discussion because obviously it's the amputation of claws. And we don't want to do it if you don't have to, but some cats are really dangerous. And let's, for instance, say your mother owns a cat and her cat scratches and she's suddenly on warfarin or one of these blood thinners and a little scratch is significant.
Yeah.
You have to, in certain circumstances, to keep these animals, do extreme things.
Okay.
You can do it very safely and under anesthesia and pain, or less pain. It's not painless.
Right.
And so my suggestion is, yes, go ahead and do them. Do it if you need to. Don't do it if it's a nice cat and it's not screwing things up. But if it's medically, there's a reason, do it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Last one, I'm interested in adopting a dog for the family. What's the best breed for young children?
Well, I have to tell you, this is a great breed. This particular breed, one of the nice things about little toy poodles for young children is, first of all, they're smart. And by the way, any breed is a good breed if it's smart.
And trained appropriately.
Yeah, and any breed's a disaster, plague upon the earth if it's not trained properly. Mm-hmm. The one thing interesting about these dogs is they don't shed. How cool is that? So they can jump on your daughter's bed or your son's bed, and there's not hair all over the place.
Good.
And that also helps with controlling allergies.
Good suggestion.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dr. Kim. Nice
My
to
pleasure.
See you. And thank you, James.